by the South Dakota Center for the Book. Last spring, you all received a copy of The Miraculous Journey of Edward Tulane. So that book has a special seal on the cover of it showing that it was the 2014 Young Readers book, the very first one for South Dakota. So we thank So your clapping is your way of thanking the South Dakota Humanities Council and the Center for the Book for producing this book for us. But also, I'm going to read the names of a few other people and a few other organizations who have helped to make sure that you all have this opportunity today. It includes the AWC family.
I'm so glad to see all of you this morning. And did you see how gorgeous the cedar was when you came in? It's like astonishingly beautiful. It's actually kind of scary to be up here on the stage in front of this many people. I think I'm not going to do this. I guess I will. Okay, I will. So what I'm going to talk to you guys about is how I became a writer, and when I finish that part of it, I'm hoping that some of you have questions about particular books, about writing in general, about the meaning of life. Anybody think they have a question like that? Raise your hand. Those are some uncertain guys. That's a different story. Okay, so back to me. Pretty soon after this picture was taken that Halloween, I got really, really sick. I got pneumonia, and I ended up in the hospital. And since this was so long ago, they were still using things like oxygen tents. So I was in an oxygen tent, I had a really high fever, and I was just really, really sick. And I hated being in the hospital. Here's a picture of me in the hospital with the hospital ID thing on. That was like for a hospital yearbook because I was such a good customer. I guess that's why they took my picture in there. And so I spent most of that winter in the hospital. I was alone a lot. I was afraid most of the time, and I felt really, really lousy. Plus, there were these nurses who wore white dresses, white stockings, and white shoes, and had these big white caps on their head that looked to me like ships, kind of like this. And these nurses only ever said one thing to me, which is, "You are a very, very sick little girl." And when somebody with a shift on their head tells you that you're very sick, you tend to believe them. So that was the first winter. The second winter, I was back in the hospital again. This is me. So I'm glad that I kept going. For a long time, the world said this, no, 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 until the world said what? Yes! And that yes, that first yes, turned into this book, which I know you guys know. Being up at the top of the Citrus Tower and seeing all of those patterns. Everything made sense. Everything's orderly. A story makes me feel that way. And this feeling of where's my dad, I get to work through those questions and the stories that I tell. So that is how I became a writer. And now you guys, if we can bring the lights up, we're going to ask me questions. And because this is such a super excellent sound system, I can come to you. So where did Because of Winn-Dixie come from? So I had moved from Florida. You guys know what Florida is like, because most of you have been to Disney World. And I moved to Minneapolis. And I wrote that book during my second winter in Minneapolis, which was one of the worst winters on record. You guys know what that means, too. So that meant for 3 days in a row, the high was 37 degrees below zero. And like when I opened up my car door, pieces of it had frozen and they would fall off. So if you grew up in Florida and it's 37 degrees below zero, where do you want to go? Florida. And I couldn't afford to go back home. But I could write a book that took me there, because that's where Because Winn-Dixie takes place. And also, it was the first time in my life I'd been without a dog. I couldn't have one in the apartment where I was. So how many of y'all have dogs? That's so nice. How many have cats? Okay. All right. So I couldn't have a dog, so I made up a dog. I made up Winn-Dixie.